So today we are going to discuss the first problem of ATCOTA regular contest 132, which is permutation grid. So we are given two permutations of R and C, where R denotes the number of black cells in the ith row of the matrix, and CI denotes the ith column, the number of black cells in the ith column. We have to there will be q queries given in the form of R1, C1. We have to find what is the color of the cell in the matrix Ri, Ci. Okay. So let us take the example here. So this is the example 5, 2, 4, 3, 1 and 4, 2, 3, 4, 5. So this means the first row will contain 5 black cells. Second row contains 2, third row contains 3, fourth row contains 4, fifth row contains 1, and same for this. First column contains 4, second column contains 2, like that. So here is the given configuration. And another one important thing here is that there is only one valid permutation possible, valid matrix possible, that is clearly mentioned here. There is exactly one way to paint the grid to satisfy the grid condition. Okay, so now let's see what is happening. So if the R and C both are a permutation, so if Ri equals to 5, then all the column of this of this row will be painted like black. And if Ci equals to 5, then all the rows of this column will be painted black. So if now, let's say, if Ri equals to 1, then what will happen? If Ri equals to 1, then what will happen? If Ri equals to 1, then the column with Ci equals to 5 will be painted black, obviously. Yeah, that is common, because in the column, this Ri cell will be also painted black, right? So, and same goes for the column. If Ci equals to 1, let me name as Cj. If Cj equals to 1, for this cell, for this row, the value of Rij, Aij will be obviously black, and other all values of this column will be white. That is confirmed. So so what we can say, if that if Rj is 1, then the column which the value of this is set, so that means A of j comma k, jth row and kth column is set, will be obviously R of k will always be 5. Okay, if A Rj equals to 1 and Aj comma k is black, then R of k will be 5, like R of k equals to n. If in our case, the first example, n equals to 5, so I am taking 5 as an example. Okay, so if R of j equals to 1 and aj k is black, then R k will be equals to 5. Same goes for column. Same goes for column. If C k equals to 1, and let me name as something else. Let's say C p equals to 1, and C p k is equal to black. APK equals to black, CP equals to 1 and AP comma K equals to black, then obviously column row of K should be 5. Okay, here I think this will be column of K is 5. I think this is column. Okay. I hope you understood. The same will go for, if you can check, if Rj equals to 2, then the columns where this is set, this value, for the columns, let's say for columns AK1 and AJ, K1 and AJ, K2, this value is set. Then K1 and K2 will be R of C of K1, C of K2 will be 5, 4. Obviously, it will happen. So what we are saying here is that if the minimum of our row and column value is, let's say, X, then it will be. I think it is not the thing. If our row value is X, the value of our row is x, then the columns which it is set will be n minus x plus 1 to n. From this column to this column, our value will be set inclusive. Okay, same goes for the column. If column value is y, then for row equals to n minus x plus 1, n minus y plus 1 to n, our value of this will be set. So let me go to the code to explain you my code here. I have taken inputs here. Now x comma y, I have converted into zero waste indexing, and we are taking a minimum of rx comma cy and our maximum of rx comma cy. It is not mandatory, but I have done it like for convenience. So if q greater than equal to n minus p plus 1, here I have said that if q is greater than equal to n minus p plus 1, then our answer will be black, else our answer will be white. I hope you have understood this concept and this solution of the problem. If you have understood the problem, please like, share, and subscribe to my channel. Thank you.